Hey there, fellow travelers. Mark here with Walter's World, and today we're here at Mount Rushmore. And today we're going to talk about some of the little mistakes that tourists make when they come to the U.S. And the first mistake is getting upset when the Americans count continents a little bit differently. Here in the U.S., we have seven continents: North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Asia, Antarctica, and Australia. And the thing is, other places around the world, sometimes they combine North America and South America into the Americas, and they only have six. So don't get upset if we count a little bit differently here in the U.S., all right? Now, let's see some more of this beautiful country to talk about some of the other mistakes you might see. So now we're here in Cheyenne, Wyoming, and my next mistake that I see tourists make when they come to the U.S. is thinking that no one will understand them when they talk smack in a foreign language. Look, you can talk smack in German, Italian, Spanish, Portuguese, Chinese, whatever, and you may think no one's gonna understand you, but you'll be surprised how many people actually will understand you, okay? I mean, I've been on trips. I remember we were in New Orleans, my buddy and I were sitting there, and these two guys were talking about these girls. They were speaking German, and they were talking about these two cute girls up there, and the two girls turn around, and they're like, we had German in college, and they're like, oh my goodness. It was pretty funny. So don't think you can go around and talk and smack in Italian or Portuguese or Japanese or whatever, and you won't have a local be like, dude, we understand what you're saying. Now, I'm not saying everybody will understand, but don't think it's gonna be a secret language, you know, just in case, all right? Now, another mistake I see tourists make when they come is they get really upset when people ask for their ID when they buy alcohol or cigarettes. Look, and lots of places around the world, you never have to show an ID. If you look like you're older than 15, they're like, sure, you can buy that. In the US, that's not the way. The reason why they're so strict with it, if they get caught selling without asking for ID, or they sell to someone that's underage, they can get a really big fine, and people don't want to pay that fine. So it's just, hey, look, I don't want to lose my job. I don't want to get a ticket. Can I just see your ID? And the thing is, it's not just the person buying. They could ask the ID for the person with them, okay? So have your passport with you. Have an ID with you that shows your age if you're going to be buying alcohol or cigarettes. Even if you look like an old fart like me, sometimes I have to show my ID still, okay? So take it as a positive. You just look really young, okay? And when you're talking to those locals, another mistake I see tourists make is they don't ask the locals for advice. Look, when you're in the U.S., we're very gregarious people. We like to talk. We like to share. We like to tell you, oh, this is the greatest place to get this. We have best steaks down the road here. But if you're going to get Rocky Mountain oysters, they've got them right there at the Albany. And so you want to take in the local flavor, right? So you got to ask the locals. And the thing is, a lot of us now, we use the TripAdvisors, we use the Yelps, and we base everything we do on that, which a lot of times is good. But wouldn't you want to know from an actual local versus a lot of tourists just writing reviews? So make sure you take the time to talk to the locals. Don't make the mistake of ignoring them. Take in their advice and learn, because you might find out that, oh yeah, you can actually go to this museum. It's free on Tuesdays, and you can go get really good food here. And they've got actually free beer samples over there. I'm like, free beer? Hold on. Because honestly, if you go to Ybor City in Tampa, you want to make sure that you get the right Cuban sandwich when you go, because you got to order it the right way when you're down there. And the locals will help you out with that. Now, another mistake I see, and I've talked about this in other videos, but I think it's important to talk about again, is the mistake of not tipping. Look, I would say not tipping and then giving some excuse. In the US, servers, bartenders, waiters, waitresses, they make their living off of tips. You are not going to change the system by saying, I don't agree with tipping. This is wrong. I will never tip. They should get paid more. This is me saying that they should get paid more. I'm not going to support those business owners that are doing that. Look, you're not doing that. All you're doing is being cheap. Okay? You like the food, how it's cheap in the US? Well, part of that is because they don't have to put on the service charge and pay the waiters and stuff as much, and so they have lower food prices, so therefore it's up to you to tip. So 15 to 20% when you go to a sit-down restaurant, that's a typical tip in the US, okay? So don't make the mistake of not tipping, because I guarantee if you go back to that same restaurant, they'll remember you. So I'll leave Cheyenne here and let's go see more beautiful parts of the US. So continuing on with our mistakes that tourists make in the US, we're here in Atlanta, Georgia. And my next mistake I have for tourists is they don't buy the insurance package when they buy their plane tickets. Look, your insurance back home may only cover your insurance back home. Make sure you have insurance for your trip, not just in case the trip gets canceled, but also for health insurance purposes, because health insurance and health issues in the US are crazy expensive. you need to go to the ER, you could be out a few grand, okay? A lot of times when you buy international tickets, they'll give you the option to get extra insurance when you do that. Make sure you pick it up or talk to your insurance provider back home to see if your insurance will be working there, because man, I mean, having a few thousand dollar bill on your credit card can be a bit tough, okay? So just have a heads up for that. Another mistake I see tourists make is they don't sign up for the loyalty programs. Look, here in the US, we love our loyalty programs. Yes, I'd love to collect my miles so I can get a free flight. Yes, I would love to collect my hotel stay so I can get a free night in a hotel. Yes, I'd love a free upgrade because I'm a member of this program. Or my personal favorite, hey, if I'm a member of your hotel thing, I get free internet? Yes, yes you do. So make sure if you're gonna be coming to the US and you're gonna travel around, sign up for those loyalty programs. Maybe you're gonna be Hilton Honors or Marriott or IHG, whatever. Get that, because if you're here for 2 weeks, it adds up very quickly. And so you might get a night or two for free in a hotel or an upgrade to a nicer room or free waters or free Wi-Fi. It does make a difference. And the thing is, those loyalty programs, it's not just for Delta Airlines and Marriott hotels. No, they have that for stores and restaurants and things like that. So make sure you do sign up for those to get the benefits, okay? Because those little benefits add up over time to make a big thing. It's another mistake we see is people don't look for the deals or just ask about the deals. Look, there's gonna be coupons for all kinds of stuff you go to here in the US. For example, we went to the Georgia Aquarium, one of the best aquariums in the world here in Atlanta, okay? And we went there and they're like, wait, it's almost 4 o'clock. Why don't you go buy your ticket online and you can save $10? I'm like, wait a minute, I'm here in line wanting to pay you right now. They're like, no, go on your phone and buy it there and you can save money. I'm like, I didn't know that. That's why it's important to look, but also it's very important to ask, do you have any specials? Do you have any deals? Are there any discounts? Because there really are a lot here in the US. It can be a Groupon kind of thing. You can do that. I know even if you're ordering pizza, let's say you got a family. Oh, we just need one large pizza. That's $19.99. Well, what you should do is ask, hey, do you have any specials today? And they might have, well, we have two medium pizzas for $10. Wait, that's a lot better deal. Yeah. Little things like that, they're all over the US. If you're here in the summer, your can of Coke might have a discount to a Six Flags or an amusement park. So you do those things to kind of save a little money. And as tourists, when they come to the US, they might not know about these things. So make sure you're looking and also make sure you ask. Your hotel might have discounts yourself. Hell, this restaurant behind me here, we got a 10% discount because our hotel knows the people. They gave us a card because we asked. So make sure you do that. And the last mistake I want to talk about here in Atlanta, because you notice I'm here in Atlanta and you think Atlanta, Georgia, it's hot, it's humid, it's horrible. Well, yes, in July and August, but not in January and not in February or December or March. Look, the mistake is people choose the wrong times to visit different places in the US. You really need to look and make sure, is that a good time to visit? So for example, Atlanta. In the summer, when it's 100 degrees Fahrenheit or 40 degrees Celsius and a bajillion percent humidity, it's not fun here. I'm not gonna lie to you. This town is awesome, but not when it's freaking 100 degrees and 100% humidity, okay? So you think about it, if you're in the Southeast, hurricane season from July to November, Minnesota is a gorgeous state to visit, but do you wanna go there in February when it's freezing cold and lots of snow? I mean, these are things you gotta think about. And the thing is we get tempted to go to places because we get a cheap airline ticket, but you might not get as much bang for your buck if you go there in the wrong time of the year. That's why it's important to look at the seasons. One of the mistakes I see a lot of people make is they go to Disney World between Christmas and New Year's. That is the busiest time of the year. That is like the worst time to go because they don't know. So make sure you're checking to make sure that you have the right times to visit places because they make a big difference. Anyway, let's leave Atlanta and go to someplace a little more rural out there to enjoy some more of the US and some of the mistakes we all make when we come visit. So now we're here in Jackson, Wyoming, and my next mistake that I see tourists make when they come visit the US is they don't pay attention to their surroundings. I know if you watch the news, it seems like that there's something bad happening everywhere in the US all the time, and that's just not the case, okay? The US in general is a very safe place to visit, and you'll have a great time, and you really won't have to worry too much. But that doesn't mean you don't need to pay attention when you're walking around cities or you're exploring national parks. You do need to be aware of your surroundings, because that magic fanny pack doesn't doesn't protect you here either, okay? So make sure you're paying attention when you're going to your hotel. Ask them, hey, are there any parts of town I shouldn't be going to or I should avoid? If you're gonna be out exploring, going to the national parks and stuff like that, you know what? They say don't go off the path for a reason. It could be rattlesnakes, it could be bears, it could be, you know, just for safety's sake. Just make sure you are paying attention to your surroundings. And if you're looking at hotels, you find hotels that are super, super cheap compared to the other places that you're finding, there might be a reason for that. So do make sure you're paying attention. Now, since I'm here in Jackson, I probably have to mention something about the national parks, because Grand Teton National Park is right up there and Yellowstone National Park is just a little bit farther north of here. And mistake I see tourists make, if you're gonna be going exploring a lot of the National Park Service sites around the US, make sure you pick up the America the Beautiful Pass. Basically, it's a year-long pass that lets you in to all these National Park Service, you know, sites and parks and national monuments and stuff like that. And if you go to two or three, it really pays for itself and it makes life so much easier when you have it. So don't make the mistake of not getting that, especially if you're gonna be out here in the northwest of the US, which has a lot of really beautiful national parks that you can go and enjoy. But honestly, it can help out anywhere you go. Now, another mistake I see tourists make when they come here, and there's some restaurants behind me here which made me think of this, is don't make the mistake of not asking for a doggy bag. Look, a doggy bag is when you have the extra food after you eat, you can take it home. Because I'll be honest, a lot of places in the US, the portions they give you are enough for two people. I mean, that's why I weigh as much as two people, because I eat one American serving, which is the biggest two normal person servings. So don't be embarrassed, don't be shy to ask for a doggy bag or a to-go bag or a to-go box and take it back to your hotel, microwave it, heat it up, eat it later, take it back to your Airbnb, because you will get a lot of food. So I have seen a lot of tourists going, well, we don't ask for doggy bags where I'm from. I'm like, well, you're in the US now, it's totally okay. And some of those places might actually throw in you some more bread rolls or something like that as well. So why not get two meals paid for? Well, just pay for one meal, but actually get two out of it, okay? Now, another mistake I see tourists make, it's when it comes to driving. And I know in my don'ts videos and shocks video, I talk about the distances, so I'm not gonna talk about that. What I am gonna talk about are the little driving nuances in the US that sometimes travelers don't notice or don't know. One thing you'll see is in some places, not everywhere, like in New York you can't do this, or New York City you can't do this, but turning right on a red. In a lot of places in the US, you actually can turn right on red. If there's no traffic coming and if it's safe, you can go. It's almost like a yield when you're taking a right turn. Now, it's not everywhere, so you need to have a heads up for that. And some places will have a special sign saying, no right turn on red. But that is some things that sometimes you might be sitting there waiting to turn red and people might honk at you and you're like, what, the light's red. That could be one of the reasons why. Also, another thing, left lane driving. Look, if you're on the highways, if you're slower, you stay to the right, you pass in the left lane. I know this is how it is in a lot of countries, but it seems like when people travel, they forget that. Now, another mistake I have for you here in Jackson is, don't make the mistake of believing all the stereotypes you hear about the US, okay? I know you think everyone in the US eats a pound of bacon for breakfast and then goes shoots their gun in the afternoon. Look, that's not the case. I mean, it's not everybody from California is a surfer dude, and everybody that's from the Southeast is a redneck, and everybody from New England is so prim and proper, and the Midwesterners are all shucksy. Yes, there's a lot of stereotypes out there about the US, and one of the things I always tell people, go travel and meet the people on your own, because it doesn't matter if you're in the North Pacific Northwest or the Southeast, the Northeast, the Midwest, or wherever in the US, Americans are actually super friendly people. And they're gonna wanna help you. They're gonna want you to go see these things. They're gonna want you to know more about their country and see more of their region. And they're gonna give you the helpful tips about, hey, this is where you wanna go eat. This is not the place to go eat. Cause they're the ones, they're gonna hook you up with a really good local food. So make a friend with some of those locals when you do drive around. And don't believe the stereotypes, except for the friendliness, cause there really are a lot of friendly Americans. So that's what I have from Jackson. Let's go see another beautiful part of the US.
One of the big mistakes that I see people make when they come to the United States is that they just come here and they go to the big cities, New York, LA, Chicago, Atlanta, great cities with a whole lot to offer you. But nearby those big cities are smaller towns. And if you're not checking those out, you're missing out on some really great programming, small town festivals, and really good Americana. For instance, not too far outside Atlanta is the Elder Mill Covered Bridge. It's in this lovely area, and we're only an hour and a half away. We went to a really great farmer's market yesterday that had all sorts of arts and things. So just by leaving those big cities for just a day to see something interesting, you'll find a whole new side of America. Related to that is the mistake of not getting off the interstate. You come here, you have to drive in America to really see it all, to get a real good flavor of what there is. But when you do that, you tend to get on the interstate and you go from point A to point B. Get off the interstate. Get off the interstate, get on a back road, get on a highway that's like kind of like a Route 66 kind of thing when you're going from Chicago to LA, and you get to see these small towns and get a whole new flavor of the United States. You'll discover a lot of hidden beauties as you come around this great country of ours on the back roads. And as you're going from one state to the other, there are often visitor centers, especially if you're on the interstate, but sometimes on the back roads, there'll be a small kiosk and stuff with all sorts of information about nearby activities, whether it's outdoor stuff, hiking, biking, things like that, or festivals, or just great places to eat and sleep. There are all sorts of things that you can stop on the road and see something new. So you'll find a lot of different stuff to do in a lot of different states. And I hope that when you come here to the US, you'll get out and explore some of the small things on the small state highways and things, and not just the big stuff.
And the thing is, no matter where you are in the US, we hope you have a great time. And these aren't mistakes or anything bad. These are just things that you can do to help enjoy your visit to the US even more. So I'm going to say thank you and bye from here in Georgia.
Bye,
y'all. In the United States.
Yeah, of course.
There you go.
Bye.